I'm travelling the length and breadth of the country to explore some of the most incredible homes Ireland has to offer. Irish architecture is often understated, but now starting to be recognised as a serious player, building its reputation around the world. This is very different to the big city of Shanghai. Do you love it?
Sure, for sure.
Now, my next house has a story that was born in Toronto, Canada. When I was there last February, I went to see a building by one of my favourite architects, Will Alsop. The Sharp Centre for Design is a beautifully playful building, and its thin, delicate support legs are a feat of engineering. Well, now I'm in the west of Ireland, and I've heard about an Irish architect who worked with Will for 15 years. Recently, he's put everything he learned into building his dream family home in a field outside Limerick. There it is, Meadow Dance. It's really striking to find something like this, how light and how airy and delicate the whole thing feels. Colours are very vibrant. They're not apologising for themselves there. They're not muted tones. Are they meadow flowers? Everything is kind of starting to die off now, but I'd say when this is all in full bloom, you'd see these very strong colours. I suppose with a lot of Irish houses, or houses in general, you start to see forms and shapes that are familiar. There is nothing familiar about this project, about this house at all. Architect John Curran built this home for his family in 2019, and after 16 years living in Shanghai, they moved in just 6 months ago.
Dermot!
Hey John!
Wow!
How are you?
Great to see you.
And you must be Ying.
Yes!
How are you? Hi Alex, how are you? What a great house.
Delighted you like it.
It's very dramatic, John.
Dramatic good,
yeah.
I think.
Oh no, in a good way.
Yeah.
Photographs don't do it justice. I don't think you get the sense of drama that the height has.
There was always this desire to make this double height space, this family parlour space.
Yeah.
You know, we're coming from Shanghai where we lived in a shoebox apartment. So it's like you always want what you don't have.
Yeah.
And this was our chance. We wanted everything together. So we've got our kitchen one end, seating around the stove the other, the all-important kitchen table.
Yeah.
Where we lived most of our life at, you know, eating, kids doing their homework, mum and dad planning the next day. This is where it all happens.
It all happens in one room. So this is it. Like it's everything. You don't have separate sitting rooms, a good dining room, all the things that Irish houses would generally have.
All the things that we're trying, clients to convince them maybe not to do. So many cellular little spaces.
Was this the ultimate dream? To have space, this amount of garden, this amount of land, this amount of space.
It is, Ying. Is this your dream?
I think so. Because I like green things, like flower, vegetable.
Yeah.
In China, actually, we have huge big balcony, but the balcony for me is not enough.
The house is called Meadow Dance, and you've left it really natural. Like it's a very un-Irish thing to do. We tend to build our house and then manicure a garden the entire way around it, but you very intentionally left it all wild outside.
The house blossoms out of a meadow, right? And this was my mother's meadow. She passed away in 2014.
Yeah.
I have very fond memories of my mother walking through the meadow here, picking wildflowers.
Yeah.
And so, you know, that's what it...
That was intrinsic to the design.
It's tribute to her, you know, because, you know...
Can we go upstairs and have a look?
Sure.
Right, after you. Off the generous upstairs landing are two kids' bedrooms and this beautifully pared back and zen-like master suite.
Oh, wow. That's an amazing view, isn't it?
That's the bog. I'm a bog man. I'm in love with this bog. The trees are opaque with leaves right now. They'll soon lose their leaves and you'll see this incredible rich patch quilt of brown and yellow heather extending off into the distance.
For being very close to a city is magical. Yeah. It really is, isn't it?
It is. We're very lucky. We're very fortunate. And we are enjoying waking up to this. I didn't want that glass handrail there at all.
You could imagine, actually, without the glass here, that you could just dangle your legs out over the edge.
I did it, and I loved it, and I wanted to be that way, but, you know, building codes must be complied with, right?
Yeah.
Safety first.
But it would be a bit like, you know, hanging out over the edge of a boardwalk with your fishing rod or something like that.
I love it, yeah.
First impressions, I really like it. There's a lovely play of light everywhere, especially with the cladding along the side there. It kind of gives this lovely dappled light.
Ying was a fashion designer in Shanghai, but here in Ireland, she's happily swapped fabrics for flowers.
This is very different to the big city of Shanghai.
Yeah.
Do you love it?
Sure, for sure.
Space
all like today.
Yeah.
I like the older place. I like the big land.
Yeah.
Because I farmed the nature, I like flower.
Yeah.
If here, if I like, I can go whatever I want.
Okay, this freedom to grow.
Yeah.
Because it's a meadow.
Yeah.
Ying has really embraced living in the meadow and spends as much time as she can in her polytunnel.
So this is your piece of heaven down here, is it?
Yeah. Actually, sometimes when I and John, we have a small fight.
Yeah.
I go there.
You go there? I'm dying to see this. Wow. Oh my God, you've been busy.
Oh, they go like a monster. Actually, I don't know how to do with them. Look, they're like monster.
They're like monsters, I love them.
Yeah.
It's the Irish soil.
Yeah. Look at my chili.
Oh, chilies, you're growing chilies.
Yeah.
I didn't think you could grow chilies in Ireland.
While Ying discovers the magic of Irish soil, John designs high-profile buildings all over China. A large section of the ground floor is given over to this impressive design studio.
We've designed everything from a cruise terminal in the centre of Shanghai to a sports stadium in Zhoushan. And Dermot, we're small, we're 20 people, but we've managed to design and realise 700,000 square metres in the space of 16 years.
The most eye-catching detail on this home has got to be the light floating bedroom block, delicately held up by Will Alsop's maverick support structure, which of course, John helped him to design.
Some people think they might be whimsical, but there is a structural reason for it. So if you imagine that this flying wing is supported on vertical columns, the columns would be incredibly fat, and we'd also have cross bracing.
Yes.
What these do, they triangulate the forces and they stop the racking in this direction and in this direction, in two directions.
It's a really serious structural solution to holding up a big, heavy first floor.
It saves on a lot of materials as well as an economy of steel.
For most of us, we're constantly searching for these symbols, like the pitched roof or the stone walls or the thick walls or the deep, you know, all of these symbols of an Irish house. He hasn't limited, he hasn't tied himself, he hasn't shackled himself to any of those notions. What he has done is he's used his life experience, married with his childhood memories, to create what I think is a building that is loaded with integrity. It's fun, it's dynamic. This is a house that literally dances through the meadow. Meadow dance.